Welcome, I'm Anna Gletley. In a continuation of Unit 1, we're going to be talking and looking at the different types of simple epithelium. All right, as I mentioned in the previous video lecture, you have squamous epithelium and it's going to be flat and thin. If it's one layer, then we call it simple squamous epithelium. And remember, it's always important to put the full name, simple squamous epithelium. So single row of cells. So when you're looking at structure of the cells, the tissue, this is really important because it tells you what the function of that tissue is. So anytime you have a cell type that is really thin and one row, it means it's really easy for things to rapidly move across them. All right, so simple squamous is really functionally important for places where you want to do diffusion, okay? This area will also secrete some serous fluid, and where you're gonna find it, locations, the alveoli of the lungs, glomeruli of the kidneys, endothelium, so this is the epithelium that lines the inside of arteries, and the serosa, which is where you get the serous fluid, okay? So this is important, all right? You need to memorize the function right there. So for every type of epithelium, what I want you to be able to do is ID it. I want you to tell me its function. And even if you can't remember it for one specific thing, if you can look at the shape of it, you can get a pretty good guess as to what the function is. And then a location in the body. So I'm usually not asking for like absolutely correct identification of an organ yet. That's more A&P2. What I want is, can you give me an example of where you would find it in the body? Okay, so we are going to look at the structure of the epithelium. So I am now going to be over here. Now notice here, I have a free edge. Because I have a free edge, I know I have epithelium. Now I'm going to look at the tissue shape. So there's my cell. I can see that my cell is so thin that all I'm really noticing is the nucleus. I mean, that's how thin it is, okay? So each one of those is outlining the cell. So it's one row, so then I know it's simple, all right? And because it's so flat that I can't see anything but the nucleus, I know it's squamous. Okay, now because I know that epithelium is always next to connective tissue, I know that I have some type of connective tissue proper right there, and we'll look at that later. Okay, now coming over here to this one, okay, same thing. You can see the cell, all right, you can see the squamous shape. It's one row, so it's simple squamous. This is my free edge, which is apical. This is my basal layer, which is attached to CT. Okay, let's go on to the next slide. All right, so the big picture right here, all right, this is what you're usually going to see when we're looking at connective tissue proper. You're gonna be seeing kind of a side view, okay? So right here, we are looking at a glomerulus in the kidney, and what I have are these really thin cells right here. So again, I've got a free edge, all right? Here's my CTP on the basal edge, all right? It's thin, flat, one row, so therefore it is simple squamous. Okay? Now, over here, this is a superior inferior view, so top down, okay? And what you can see is what the actual shape is. So you can see it's kind of like this hexagonal funky shape. And then right there is my nucleus. Now this is actually from a cheek swab, so technically this is stratified squamous, but because of the way it's smeared on this slide, you can see the individual cells. We are almost never going to look at that. In fact, we're never going to look at that except for on that type of a slide. So this is what you really need to know, is you need to be able to recognize this thin stuff over here. All right, next slide. All right, here's another view of simple squamous epithelium. So this is the lumen of a tube, So the lumen is just the cavity that fluids are going to flow through. All right, so that's right there. And that's where your free edge is going to be. So right here, I can see I've got cells. Now right there, the nucleus has been cut out. So right there, basically right there, here. So I've got a free edge. I've got connective tissue proper on this side. It's one row, flat. So it's simple squamous. Okay, next slide. All right, now we're gonna move on to the simple cuboidal, okay? So again, single layer of cells, and they're going to be square to roundish. Typically, they're pretty, they might be kind of like this, but they're mostly square or cube shape, okay? Now, whenever you've got something with a lot of room in it, that means it's got room for the organelles that make stuff. All right, simple squamous, it can do diffusion of fluids, so like for serous fluid, but it's not got the room to make a lot of proteins or lipids or hormones or any of that stuff. It's too flat, there's no room for the organelles, much less making something else. But with a cuboidal cell or a columnar cell, I can have a big fat nucleus, I can have lots of mitochondria, I can have lots of endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparati. So those are the things that are making stuff. So what this does is it makes stuff and it secretes it. All right, so like mucus, all right? It can absorb stuff, alter it, and then re-secrete it, all right? Then if I tack some cilia on it, all right, it can move stuff across its surface. Now it's only gonna do movement if cilia is present. So where do you find it? Lining tubes and ducts, okay? Common liver, thyroid, etc. Okay? So this you need to know. Function, okay? Absorption and secretion are the primary functions, okay? Give me locations of where you would find in the body. Okay, now let's look at the structure of the cell. So I've got a free edge, and I have connective tissue proper right there. I have one row of cube-shaped cells, so it is simple cuboidal. Okay, next slide. All right, here's an example of a slide we would see in the lab. So I have a follicle. I have some kind of hormone that's inside this follicle. All right, so this is a free edge, okay? Over here is my connective tissue proper, and I can see I have a single row of cube-shaped cells. So I have simple cuboidal epithelium. Now, I wanna contrast this with this slide up here, okay? When you are looking at tissue slides, almost never will you have only one type of tissue present. So here, I can see I have, right there, simple squamous, okay? But then, right next to it, I have a tube where I've got simple cuboidal, okay? And then here, I have connective tissue proper. Here, I have another type of epithelium that's actually in the form of little arterioles, and we'll talk about that in A&PI too. Not arterioles, sorry, capillaries. Okay, we'll look at that later. Okay, so right there, simple cuboidal. On this slide, I've already got 1, 2, 3, 4 types of tissue present, and that's normal. And you want to start looking for those things. You want to be looking for changes in color, consistency, content, size of shells, cells, shape of cells, all of those types of things. Next slide. All right, so now we're looking at a kidney tubule. All right, so again, I have my free edge here. I have my connective tissue on the basal layer. Here is a simple cuboidal, so one row of cube-shaped cells. So this is simple cuboidal epithelium. Next slide. Oh, wait. And then you can see nicely right here, I have simple squamous right there. Here's some really good ones right here. Simple squamous epithelium there. So that is simple squamous. So again, I'm seeing both types of tissue on this slide, and that is normal. All right, simple columnar epithelium. All right, so what you are dealing with is a single row of columnar or rectangular shaped cells. The nucleus tends to be oval and it tends to float towards the basement membrane, but it doesn't have to. All right, now here, right there, I am seeing microvilli. Sometimes you will see cilia. Cilia and microvilli are not the same thing. Make sure you know the difference between the two of them, okay? Function, all right? They have lots of room, all right? They're big cells, big nucleus, lots of organelles like mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes, Golgi apparatus. They can make stuff. So they're really good at secreting mucus or hormones. So they make it, they secrete it. So what is their function? Absorption and secretion. If cilia is present, they will move stuff along their surface, like they will move mucus along the surface or an egg along a fallopian tube, okay? Location, so here's some examples of where you would find it, okay? Right over here, I've listed the GI tract tends to not be ciliated. So parts of the GI tract have microvilli, other parts do not, okay? Cilia is really common in the respiratory tracts and the genitourinary tracts, all right? Next slide. Oh, actually, let's really quickly mention this. Right here is a goblet cell. So goblet cells tend to be kind of like this shape. All right, there are modified epithelial cells, so you can see its nucleus right here. And what this is it's filled with something that's being made and secreted. In this case, it's probably mucus. And then that's gonna spill out onto the surface right here. And over here on the left, you can see the same thing, and then there's the nucleus. This is often found in simple columnar epithelium, not always, but often. You can also find it in PCCE or pseudostratified, okay? Next slide. All right, so now we are looking at another example of simple columnar. I have my free edge. I have my connective tissue proper. All right, I can see I have one row of cells. All right, so they are simple. They're columnar in shape. And I don't know, can you see these? There's like these little fuzzy things that are sticking up to the top. Technically, this is also ciliated. So this would be ciliated simple columnar epithelium. The cilia wasn't present, it would just be simple columnar epithelium. Next slide. All right, so let's now look at our pseudostratified epithelium. I've got two abbreviations that are commonly used because it's really long to write pseudostratified, okay? So PCE, pseudostratified, columnar epithelium. Now PCCE is pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. All right, I know that's hard to read, but you get the idea. So pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium, whereas this is pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. Now, both of the pictures here are showing you the ciliated version. All right, so what I have is a basement membrane down here, okay? I have my free edge here, and in this case, I've got lots of cilia, okay? Now, it is hard to tell, but technically, every single one of these cells is touching the basement membrane. So this is one row of cells, okay? I can also see the occasional goblet cell squashed in here. These are also all attached to the basement membrane, all right? When I am looking at this, what I notice is that my nuclei don't form neat rows. So when I'm dealing with a stratified columnar epithelium, what I see are neat rows of nuclei, okay? And you can see here, they are all over the place. They are not in neat rows at all, okay? Also, columnar, stratified columnar, by the time you put in the two rows of cells, it's really tall. Whereas pseudostratified is a fairly thin layer because technically it's only one layer of cells. So these are thinner tissues than a stratified columnar, okay? Function, absorption and secretion. If cilia is present, then it can move stuff. Where are you going to find it? Respiratory tract, parts of the male urethra, some other areas, all right? Let's look at the next slide. All right, so here is an example of PCCE, so pseudostratified. Ciliated columnar epithelium. Okay, I have a free edge, all right? I have my basement membrane with connective tissue proper. I have, and it's hard to see, it's a little, not the best slide in the world. And there's a goblet cell right there. There's another one, okay? So they're columnar in shape. Let's find some that are a little easier to see. This is not the best slide. All right, so let's actually focus on the nucleus. So there's a nucleus, there's a nucleus, there's one, there's one. So you can see they're kind of gobbled up or kind of mushed up, okay? But this is still a really thin tissue and it's still columnar in shape. And of course you can see the cilia, okay? All right, so that was the last of the slides for the simple epitheliums. In the next video lecture, we're going to look at the stratified epitheliums.